Hello everyone, welcome to iLLPhoCorPhics. Now today we are starting another exciting Adobe Photoshop tutorial, and today I'm gonna show you how can you create neon effect on your face or portrait in Photoshop. And this is a very simple and easy technique to create neon effect and make your a simple looking portrait or image into awesome looking. And this is a simple trick on the last tilde and C tilde end, so that you can understand how can you create this awesome looking neon effect on your face. So if you are new, welcome, make sure to subscribe and also press that bell icon, because I'm going to come up more exciting Adobe Photoshop tips, tricks and tutorials for you. So guys, make sure to subscribe and also press the bell icon. So without any further ado, let's jump to our Photoshop. Now you're here, the magical world of Photoshop. Now I'm going to use this beautiful portrait to show you how can you create. Now this is a very simple looking portrait, you can see that. Now when you create this neon effect, you can see how much change it and how much awesome it's going to look. Now to create the neon effect, I'm going to use a gradient layer, because I want to work non-destructively so that I can adjust them later, and I try to always work on non-destructively, and I always prefer you also to create any kind of adjustment in non-destructive layer. To do that, just go to this adjustment layer, take the gradient. Now it will come up the default color gradient, black to transparent. Now click on here and then change the color of that. Double click on here, then it will come up the color. You can also just select this one and click this color. You can come also find this color one. Now go to this color, change it. It's now going to black, and I'm not going to use on this time red color. I'm going to use first a bluish or cyan color. I can add any kind of color as you like, but in this case I'm just want to use in my preference, and you don't need to be perfect accurate. Just hit okay this time. You can add any kind of color, and I don't prefer you to use a particular color on your portrait. Just then select this one, and I think this is okay, and just kind of cyan color a little bit more. Then copy this color code, because we are going to use this color code on the other side. Now right button on your mouse, it will come up the copy, then copy, hit okay, then select this one and change the color of that. Now press that press Ctrl or Command V to paste it. You can also press the right button on your mouse, then paste it. Now it will come up, you can see the difference. So that's why I'm going to use this two side of color, same color. Now hit okay. Now we're going to adjust in later, but this case I want to first create this color effect. Now change the angle of that, press 0, it will come up the color, the angle, and change this one. Now hit okay. Now press Ctrl or Command J to duplicate it. Press Ctrl or Command J, it will duplicate. Now change the angle of that, just double click on here, then it select the reverse. Now change the color of this one. This time I'm going to use a pink, reddish pink, like that, and change this one like that, reddish pink, this kind of color. You can use any kind of color as you want. Then copy the color code, copy, then select this one and paste it over here. Now hit okay, that's great. Now hit okay and okay. Now press Ctrl or Command J to make a duplicate one, then also do the same thing. Press Ctrl or Command J, duplicate it. Now you can see it's cover up the whole image in the gradient. Now we need to change the blend mode of this four gradient. Change the blend mode all this four into overlay. Now do the same thing on this one, and also the cyan blue and this one. Now overlay is done. Now we can see we just create neon effect, but it's affecting our portrait too much. We don't want too much effect on the portrait. We want to keep the portrait the natural face, and also just create a slightly bit light effect. So that's why just double click on here and click on here. Now it will come up the gradient. Now take this slider into the around the location. You can see the location number here into 60, and change this one the location also around 60. Hit okay, hit okay. Do the same thing on here, double click, click, and change this one to 60. Do the same all the four layer in the same way. Now hit okay. Now we just apply the color, but we're not getting the actual color what we want in this portrait. To get the actual one, first you need to adjust the color contrast a little bit like that. This select this one and decrease the opacity around 60 like that, and also the fill. Now this is good. Now you can see we just created, but you can keep as you want. In the left side of this one is a blue color and the right side of the pink reddish color, you can keep it. But in this case I want some of the trick so that it only affect our portrait face, not this area, because it's not looking good on this case. But you can keep it in your own portrait, but in this case I want to change this one. Now double click on here and change the angle into 45. Just press 45, hit OK. Do the same thing on this one too, change the angle into 45. Now it's affecting too much on the face, so we need to balance overall. To balance this one, just double click on the bluish color one, then press minus 45. Now it will balance all the neon effect into the face in a natural way. Now you can see we just add it in so awesome way. Now the next thing, just group on this one, press control or command G. Now this is great. Now the second thing we are going to do, just adjustment layer, take the brightness and contrast, decrease the brightness around a kind of 40 as you like, and then increase the contrast overall around 50. I think 50 is perfect. I'll decrease this one. Now go to the again adjustment layer, take the curves and increase the contrast. Just balance overall how much brightness or contrast you like to add in your image in awesome way. So now you can see we just created our neon effect. See the before and the after one. Just this is the before and this is the after one. You can see how awesome we just create a neon effect into the portrait. It's looking awesome. So that's for it today, and I hope you like it. If you like it, smack that like button. If you don't like it, you can also click that on this like button, but I hope you like it. And you can, what do you think about my tutorial? Just let me know in the comment section below. I'm really excited to know your opinion about my tutorial, and you can also check out my other tutorials in my channel. I hope you like it, and if you are new, just guys, make sure to subscribe and also press that bell icon. You can also follow me on Facebook and Twitter. Just go in the link description and follow me. So that's for it today. See you in the next tutorial. Till then, bye. And the most important thing, guys, I always say to you, keep learning.